A lot of new information coming out today. Some of that information points to the fact that this suspect apparently planned this murder out. We'll tell you why that's one of the reasons we're in the car. We want to show you the path the killer took, or the suspected killer took, as he left the parking lot here. First, let's show you, though, this is the parking lot where this happened. You can see this is the spot where 57-year-old Stephen Chan was stabbed to death yesterday. You can see somebody's left some flowers there for him. The big news really today, though, is this. Let's show you some video right now, or some images of the suspect. And some of those images, you see him running away from the scene here. This happened in a Cal State University Fullerton parking lot yesterday around 8:30. That's when the 911 call came in, around 8:30 in the morning, about someone who was seen in a car. It ended up being 57-year-old Stephen Chan, bleeding from the head. Chan was a retired administrator here at Cal State University Fullerton, working now as a consultant here at the school. Now, those images you see, the suspect is running away from the parking lot, out of this parking lot, which is on the south side of campus off of Nutwood. One of those images that you saw, the suspect was actually running in front of a Habit hamburger restaurant and a Coffee Bean and some other restaurants in the area there. Now, if we could, I want to come back to a live shot here in a moment here. Let's get the camera set up, and we want to show you the path he took. One of the reasons we want to show you this is because not only did the suspect, according to police, leave a backpack at the scene, a backpack that had items that could be used to kidnap somebody, there were also items in there, including a wig, according to police, and a knife. Not the knife used in the murder, but basically items they say could have been used to kidnap somebody. It looked like there was some planning, and they believe that backpack was left by the killer underneath the car of the victim. Also in that backpack, they say, was an incendiary device. Now, back to why we're in the car and what we're doing right now. This area right here, this is the path that the suspect took. We're turning onto Nutwood off of the area where the parking lot was on the south side of campus. The suspect, according to police, parked on the other side of the freeway from campus. So here, over here is that Habit hamburger spot onto the right here, but on the other side of the bridge here, this is the 57 freeway. The suspect actually parked his car on the other side of the freeway, indicating again that there was planning involved in this. He did not want his car to be seen, or did not want it to be seen where, how he got away. Well, unfortunately for him, there were some cameras here between a Denny's and a Holiday Inn that caught images of his car. Let's take a look at those images now. These are images of the suspect's car that police believe he got away in. It's been described as a newer model black BMW X6. Another clue that police want to put out there, they believe that this suspect has some significant injuries on his hands.
We do believe that the suspect injured one or both of his hands. We know that there is blood that was left at the scene by the suspect, as well as in the video you can see that he is either covering his hand or there appears to be red on his hand. So we do believe that there was some sort of injury that he sustained.
So this is the parking lot, the area where they believe that he parked that getaway car. Now, the Fullerton Police Department is the one investigating this case. This happened on the campus of Cal State University Fullerton, but there's an agreement with the city of Fullerton that on bigger cases like homicides, that the Fullerton Police Department will be the lead agency. So if you recognize the suspect in those images or think you saw something that could help police find him, you can contact the Fullerton Police Department.